Hi everyone, welcome back to Best of Three. Today we are playing a Yorion deck. It is a deck also by Holy Diva. I need to figure out how to pronounce it. I believe it's Diva. They are playing another Jeskai deck. What caught my eye was playing Chance for Glory, and I love this card. Chance for Glory is a card that says creature control gain indestructible forever. Take an extra turn after this one. At the beginning of that turn's end step, you lose the game. You stop yourself from losing the game with things like getting the trials. Tail's End also works. Discontinuity can also stop the lose trigger from Transfer Glory. These are just the ones I see like off the bat. And plus you have Pact Negation, which also works with Gideon as well. If you need to, you can stop the lose part with Tail's End or discontinuity, or you can just pay it. You also have Blood Sun, which for Lotus Field, which makes Lotus Field completely untapped. We can also Tail's End Lotus Field as well, or we can discontinuity Lotus Field and make it not sack lands either. So Lotus Field should come into play untapped a decent amount of time because we have 4, 8, 9, 10, 11 ways to make it come into play untapped. I changed a few things about the deck. I'm playing Censor instead of Dwarry Disruption. And I'm playing a Secret Restoration over a second Valakut Awakening. Nothing crazy, but just diversified it a little bit. It's still by and far their list. Yeah, let's give this deck a whirl in best of three. Seems super fun. And I want to see all the stuff they can do and how it works in best of three with all this crazy nonsense. So let's try it out. Also, you can memory with Narset, and that will draw you 7 cards in your opponent, like just one card. However, if you're able to memory on your opponent's draw step, they will draw no extra cards, and you'll draw 7. And the way to do it on your opponent's draw step is to Gear Hulk, target commit, but choose the memory side of the split card. We'll mull this. Wow. Guildgate Control, huh? Actually, I have a Steam Vent, so it's not Guildgate Control, but... Uh-oh. Uh-oh. It's the colorless deck that they have there. Turn 2 Mana Rock. Tar and Karn.
I will not stop.
Forsaken Monument. This is a tough one.
I will not lose another friend.
Will not lose another friend. God, there are stars too. I feel like we're pretty far behind here. I think I'm plus on Monument, but like, if I have Seal Away, I don't care. Don't care about Seal Away. Alright, this game is over. I'm gonna have to pay for Pact on my turn anyways. And can't do much else. Spring of Braid. Double Stroke. The Sweltering Sun's on, I have to do like actual nothing. Okay, let's try this. Dragonfire also is not that great, but it kills Karn after one activation. I really don't have anything else to bring in. Try this. I like Gideon. Mana rocking gain on turn 2. Makes things a lot harder.
Show me what you can do.
Show me what you can do. Plus here.
I don't think so.
Make Gideon indestructible forever. Care about that. Narset.
Keep an open mind.
All right. They've given up. Soon do that again. Do it again. I mean, this counters all the big stuff. Stroke hits everything that I really want to stop anyways, so. Man, they always have the Mind Stone turn too. That's so crazy. Do we even just cycle this one? I'm gonna cycle it now. Just Narset.
I best against many foes. Meditate and prepare.
Just gonna have to suck it up and lose. Couple lands. As long as they don't, go like. Dang it! I've seen one turn.
Do not defy the designs of an elder dragon.
That sucks. I've seen one more turn, like, then like not have a bomb. Three turns in a row. But they did. Not the best use of this continuity with our planeswalker in play, but if I give him a turn, they're gonna get value out of Ugin. That sucks. Alright. We'll counter it, we'll bounce. I guess. Idle. They can regrow the monument, I guess. Not terrible.
Let's skip to the good part.
Plus. Okay. I think it's plus again.
Keep up the pace.
That's a shame. Like the Orion. Untap. Encounter the Transfer Glory. Alright, go. I see him dodge Ulamog. So much. Oh my god. Slow down the gas.
Don't make another move.
Don't make another move, please. Okay, something. It's going cycles if we draw. Dealt with a lot. Hopefully, they draw a few lands from now on.
I suppose that's how it was meant to happen.
Wonderful. Alright, there's a bacon. Come on, deck. Holy moly, the big snake. I guess I'll hold this in case I draw Seagate Restoration. I don't even know.
Those who cannot perceive the thoughtfulness before action.
Come on, give me like a commitment to memory. Or sublime epiphany. So that's 8. So block. Can't block there. Just dead. Yeah. break pretty hard there at the end. My opponent drew essentially gas. That's their deck, but man, that's kind of sucks. And a braid at any point with Narset would have been great. Like a braid, Epiphany, a Gear Hulk, Commit to Memory. Especially with Narset out, memory would have been fantastic. Man, we countered so many spells, it just didn't matter. And they were almost like, they were all must counters except for like Hedron Archive. But Hedron Archive would have like ramped them more and given to cards anyways. This is too risky. Well. Alright then. Alrighty then. Another Lotus Field. Go ahead and kill that. Have the mana. Lurrus already. Come on. It's rough. Sure. Spike Field Hazard. Oh my god, they're gonna shock me again. No. I'm gonna hold it. Alright, get him, Ryan. Can do it. Fine. Can't cast a spell anyways. That is not nice. Sweltering Suns.
I'm known, but let's skip to the good part.
Now I get Thought Seized again because of the Arcanist. And probably die.
That didn't go according to plan.
Did not go according to plan. Thought Seize. So dead. All right. Countered it, but it goes back to them and we die, so Doesn't really matter. Okay. Anger of the gods. All right, let's try this. No. Sure. The mana. Dossies. I hate this card. This card should not exist in Historic. It's way too powerful. I don't mind them adding it later. Like once the format gets stronger, but it's really annoying as is. Four lands. Knew it. I knew it was only four lands because, you know, we were missing land drops, so. Arena Shuffler. No way, man. That's so annoying.
Trick for this.
Yay. I'm gonna cast this if we draw Lotus Field, but we're so far behind at this point, it's kind of insane. It's kind of ridiculous how far behind we are. So we get Thought Seized again. They take Dragonfire. Bless them a hand, otherwise I just take it with Thassies. Next turn they're getting Crux on play. Did not know that card had animation, so it's kind of cool. Exile five other four other five. Right, maybe I can get that in play. Pog. And we are dead. Alright. Well, I'm not sure. Let's make them that. Those were some rough matches. And some rough mulligans. Let's take one more game. Try it in just on the ladder. Let's see how that goes. Yes. More Lurrus. Just what I wanted to play against. This is also the reason why I don't know how you can ban Uro in this format. Like, people want to ban Uro in this format. And you have this deck that makes you like discard your hand, so like your entire hand so quickly. Maybe not this exact deck, but the other deck, whatever. Thought Season recurring it is just brutal. So obnoxious for 1 mana. I don't know why they. I don't want to complain too much about it. I just don't know why they gave it to get put in historic. It's tilting. Double Thought Seize. So they basically just drew 2 cards, right? They lost 2 cards and drew 2. Oops, I mean, just a fancy divination. Second Thought Seize with the Arcanist. Got him. Another one. I want them to cast Thought Seize, or put on the stack at least. Or just cast Lurrus on the stack. Because if they put Thought Seize on the stack, I can just exile Thought Seize off the stack. Make it gone forever. Then. I'll just get rid of Lurrus then. Don't mind that one either. Teferi's gonna get Thoth seized. They have to kill Yorion first, though. They kill Yorion. Then they get Thoth seized Teferi. They killed him. Killed our snake bird. The flying snake. Or the flying noodle. That's cool. We're gonna get double Thossized. So annoying. If I had 2 mana up, I could have just countered this, but... Oh, it's so obnoxious! Take it. Take a card. Cool. The next turn, I need to sack something and draw 2 cards, or Thoughtseize again. So that was 4 Thoughts. We went Thoughtseize 4 times this game. Fun. Fun, fun.
The focus and discipline in fighting keep an open mind.
Memory should help. Memory should help. Movement courier, sure. Let's see. I think I have to kill this and make them tap out for Blood Chief's Thirst. And they get 2 Blood Chief Thirst. It's fine. Thoughtseize. Oh my god, it's the 5th Thoughtseize, whatever. They lost 10 life from bosses. Pass. Come on.
My mind needs a rest.
Give me a break, bro. Spark Harvest is also brutal there. Obviously, because if they have a Spark Harvest, we get to memory. And they can draw no cards. Or just one card, whatever. You exile two Thassies, you still do Thassies. So annoying. There's two actually exiled. It's just crazy. Six Thassies in freaking first game. Exile everything. Counter everything. All right, they can escape the Titan. Definitely counter that. Counter it, return the courier, and draw a card. And they can sack it, but they discard their whole hand. And they played land this turn, so they can't bring back the Titan. The problem is if I Sweltering Suns. They mill six more cards. I feel like I should cycle this. We have one thought seize left in the deck. Take two. Just gonna cycle this. All memory. Probably. I mean, because, like, they banks out most of their. They banks out a lot of good stuff. Also, exiled now. What a game. Perfect. Alright, that's funny.
I train every day. No one is more prepared than me.
Nice. I feel so good after getting destroyed by Thossies. All right, let's try this. I should have Good Hulk, even. It's probably fine. Just gotta try to keep the board, the battlefield clear. Dying chat. I'm dying, YouTube, I'm dying. Thought seize. No, oh, they're gonna double thought seize next turn, okay. They're gonna thought seize the Arcanist thought seize. Yeah, so fun. I'm ready for it. I'm ready. Ooh, oh. The Titan. Alright, full control. It's a lot of lands. Let's end the turn here. Don't want to lose two lands. Boom. Another one, sure. Getting blightning, 2 mana.
This isn't up, no time for a break.
Okay, well, next turn we can Leyline the Void. Three, maybe, depending on what they cast here. No rampage, please. They could have claim to fame. again. If they do it again, I'll discard Leon the Void. Can't do it again. Never gonna cast this. Keep trying to. Azob now becomes Kroxa. It's not good. Terrible draw.
Let's skip to the good part.
Can't do anything with this mana though. So we die here, right? Because they could have just Kroxed and flame famed it. We died. But now they can still Kroxa. Attack Teferi. And next turn after Yorion. Oh, they're ignoring Teferi. Please ignore Teferi. Sweet. So if I spin this, I have to spend this.
Time is much more malleable than people think.
Don't play Orion. And they escape Kroxa, I imagine. You have Thassies. You have Thassies. I can't play a spell because of Titan. Crazy top deck gore. long match. Here. You can escape. Wait, exactly lethal? Not exactly lethal, but like for 3 damage. Alright. gain. Winner take all. Sure. We have Suns, we have Narset. Don't really care about Gear Hulk here, but. We have the other stuff we want. I'm sick of this card. Sick of it! Seriously, I don't know how people enjoy that card. Oh yes, the combo. The combo. And you're so slow. We still have 20 minutes, they have 11. Yeah, sure, dress. Sling the Thoughtseize away to Fairy. Or Duress it away. They don't have hands, so they probably just Duress. Yep. Arcanist. Triple Arcanist. Anger the Gods. Not Anger the Gods. You should be able to kick Blood Chief's whatever thirst from the graveyard. And kill Yorion. Bum, bum, bum. I said one more, I didn't realize this one would take like half an hour. And they had to land for the thirst. Make him use one of the thought seizes at least, hopefully. I don't think I've been this, like, I've discarded so many cards this whole entire match. I wonder how many cards discarded this match with Kroxa, Duress, and Thought Seize. I wonder how many times they've cast a discard spell. Anger of the Gods. Anger of the gods. I mean, I'll take Sweltering Suns too at this point. So they cast this twice, that's four, that's five discard spells in game one, or game three, whatever. This is gonna get Anger of the Gods. I'm not sold on Wheel of the Void and a Yorion deck. Especially when we can't even cast it without, like, Lotus Field. Miserable games. So, this deck was fun. We played against that discard deck twice, which is really annoying. At this point, I would not play Sweltering Suns at all. Main deck, I would just play Anger of the Gods. There's too many decks that use their graveyards. I think Anger of the Gods is just a better card. I would not play Leyline of the Void. It's just not. I just don't see how you can play it in a Yorion deck with 80 cards. Odds of you having it open hands are even lower. You can't even cast it after you draw it unless you have a Lotus Field already in play. So I'm not a fan of that. I'd probably play maybe another Gideon. But in all honesty, I think the issue is with Historic is if you're not doing something like absurd, like some combo deck, like either Colorless or Neostorm, you need to be playing Kroxa or Uro. If you're not playing Kroxa or Uro, you're probably not doing it right. And that's just the unfortunate truth. You need to play one of the Titans in order to compete, or just have some absurd combo that goes way over the top, like Colorless Eldrazi deck or the Neoform combo. So yeah, that's my 2 cents on Historic and this deck. But deck was sweet. I wish we did a little better with it, perform a little better, but they all can't be winners, I guess. But thanks for hanging out. Thanks for watching. Make sure to follow me on twitter.com/AliEldrazi and twitch.tv/AliEldrazi. You can check out my cool stuff videos. Obviously every Wednesday and Friday. If you shop at coolstuffinc.com, use code Ali5 to get 5% off your entire order. Alright everyone, thanks for watching, thanks for hanging out, and we'll see you next time.